Greetings and salutations, YouTube. Friar Chuck here, and we are back with another episode of our Fallout 4 Child of Adam Let's Play. The Child of Adam, who has now quickly become Adam's savior, I guess we'll call him. The person who Adam sent to protect the Commonwealth. Yeah, Kellogg's dead.
It's not going to work. I'm not stupid. I knew they'd send him after me.
Take it easy. Kellogg's dead.
Dead? Uh-huh. Don't you lie.
Uh-huh. I'm not lying.
Did you? Kellogg was ruthless. There's a reason the Institute... I knew they'd send him after me. And so you...
Mm-hmm.
Then what do you want with me?
I know you were part of it, and you escaped.
How the hell do you... No, it doesn't matter. Why are you even here?
I need whatever information you've got. Anything to help me get into the Institute.
I'm sorry, what? You want to get into the Institute? Never mind how nearly impossible that is. Even if you... What reason could you pop?
I'm trying to find my son. The Institute kidnapped him.
I had no...
Uh-huh.
Yeah. The Institute has taken people from the common. If your son is one of them, I can help. But I'm going to need something in return.
You help me and I'll help you.
All right. If I help you, you're going to do something for me. Before I was forced to, it could return me to normal. You understand? So if you get I think that's pretty reasonable. All right, let's talk details. First things first. You know how...
Teleporter.
Yeah, they use some sort of teleporter.
Well, well. Not many know about it. It's commonly referred to as dematerial... The relay. That means you're... Now, have you ever...
Sure.
Don't bullshit me.
Mm-hmm.
Coursers are Institute synth. Mm-hmm. Operations go wrong. A synth, they're very good at what they do.
Let's go. Just point me.
Well, I suppose every...
Yeah, that's right. We're coming for him.
Special hardware.
Right.
It's Now, I don't know exactly where you can find one. They haven't sent it. You're going to have to hunt one down. I can tell you what.
Okay. Let's get to...
Right. The primary insertion point for coursers.
Sure.
Now, the relay causes some pretty heavy interference all across.
Uh-huh.
When you get to the ruins, follow the signal. Not gonna lie, the odds aren't in your favor here.
Completed the glowing sea, and now we have leveled up, so let's figure out where we are going to put our perks. We'll just put that perk into Demolition Expert. That's maxed out. And then we'll either do Rifleman or Bloody Mess next. Thinking about doing like some side type quests to Let's travel here. Oh man. I think I want to. We need to get to the Minutemen to the point where we can go take the castle back. And I think these two missions will.
Alive.
I want to give him this. I wonder if I can make him put this bandana on. Yeah, alright. I'm not trying to cover up his ghoul face. I'm just like going into the whole like we're superheroes basically. Which means we need to do the Silver Shroud quest. Very confused. Why is there a chimney here with no fireplace? Okay, this is a location added by the plenty of exploration. You can tell by the very generic name it got, but that's okay. It's a teddy bear in the books. There's the Pridwin. Okay, we're gonna restore the air pipes. I think that's a pipe right there. This is probably a lot easier to do during the day.
How long you think it took to build?
I wonder if ghouls can breathe underwater. Do ghouls even need to breathe? That's a good question. I don't know. If you know the answer to that, leave it down in the comments. I kind of assume they don't really. If they did, they'd have serious breathing problems all the time because they don't have noses. So that's not going to be. That's not like the big question for the day. It's just something I wonder. As again, like I've said before, I know that some of y'all have way better knowledge of Fallout than I do. But the big question for today is going to be, and I really should have asked this last episode because it made more sense in that one. Of all of the wasteland creatures, and I'm including everything from any of the Fallout games, including New Vegas and Fallout 1 and 2, if any of y'all have actually played that. I haven't.
Switch on the end of the pump.
How long do you think it took to fill this thing? Decades?
Sorry, I was responding to a Snapchat. Anyway, yeah, so what wasteland creature would you consider to be, like, the most terrifying if you, either from, like, a, we'll say, okay, like, you wake up and see it for the, like, you came out of the vault, right, and you see it for the first time, you know, for you, what would be the scariest one? And as far as that goes, I mean, it's really hard to argue against the Deathclaw. It's just, you know, this giant reptilian bipedal clawed horned creature. That's just, you know, super vicious and strong and, you know, what are you supposed to do against it? So it'd be hard to argue against that. Like, I feel like the first time you see one, it would just be terrifying. Like, you know, instantly just, you know, gotta have new pants type of situation. But I kind of think the shock of the Deathclaws might, you might get used to it a little bit. But I honestly think for me, like, the most terrifying ones would either be the, the Stingwings, or the Cazadores that are in New Vegas. Ghouls just kind of, they are what they are, you know? They're not really, they're basically just zombies, and I don't think zombies would, I would find all that terrifying. You know, yeah, like, with rad roaches and bloatflies, it's like, okay, yeah, they're really big, and that's scary, but again, you'd get used to it really quick, and it's just like, oh, here you go. Blood bugs are kind of the same thing. I mean, it's a really big mosquito. I'm trying to think of some other creatures. You've got the geckos from...
What?
You've got the geckos from Fallout New Vegas. Those don't really bother me that much. What else do we have here? Talked about the Cazadores, we've talked about Stingwings.
Time to collect.
I mean, I guess if you want to count, like, okay, this, like, the super mutants and stuff, seeing a super mutant behemoth for the first time. Why does that not ignite the... That does. Huh. Dick. Yeah, seeing a super mutant behemoth for the first time would not be pleasant. You've got your centaurs that were in Fallout 3, and I would assume the other ones too. I'm not sure about New Vegas. I do think they were in Fallout 1 and 2, though. You've got the mutant hounds are just, you know, big green dogs. They're not that, you know, they're really not that scary. What else do we have? I'm trying to think if I'm forgetting anything.
Terminal.
Take my mini nuke, thank you. Let me see, what else is there? You've got the spore carriers from one of the vaults that I think was in Fallout New Vegas. Oh, I'm forgetting a couple from, I'm forgetting stuff from Fallout 76. You've got the Sheep Squatch, which is a weird, like, goat, sheep, monster thing. It kind of looks like a Deathclaw. If a Deathclaw was created based off of sheep or goat DNA instead of chameleon DNA. If that makes any kind of sense. Which I feel like it does. If you've never played Fallout 76 or seen anything about it, and you've never seen a sheep squatch, you won't really know what I'm talking about, but go look it up. And I will say, having played Fallout 76, the first time you see a sheep squatch, it is rather scary. So that's got to be up there pretty high, too.
Excuse me.
What do you want? We don't need any more trouble around here.
It's okay.
You're with the Minutemen? We sent word with... Most people don't have stock in the Minutemen these days.
So yeah, I think just as a general rule, like, oh, I forgot Rad Scorpions. Those at least are big and aren't super fast.
We're rebuilding the Minutemen from the... We're the good guys.
Glad to hear it. There's a raider gang that's been giving us trouble for weeks. Stealing food and supplies. Threatening.
Mm-hmm.
We know where they're coming.
Don't worry. I'll take care of those raiders.
Thanks, friend. If you...
Okay, so Corvega Assembly Plant. we've actually not been to yet, which is kind of funny. Yeah, I think for me, Stingwings and Cazadors would be the, Stingwings are like, I think they're mutated dragonflies with stingers, which, as a general rule, dragonflies don't have. And Cazadors are mutated tarantula hawks. And a tarantula hawk is neither a tarantula nor a bird. But luckily enough, the Cazadors, I believe, are only in Fallout 76. But yeah, let me know in the down in the comments which Fallout monstrosity that you would be the most afraid of. Either, you know, either like, okay, the first time you see it, like, it would be the most shocking. Or, just like would continue to terrify you every time you saw it, type of thing. And like I said, for me, I think the most jarring would be the Deathclaw or a Sheep Squatch, either one. And then, the continued, like, would be afraid of would be Cazadors and Stingwings. And this obviously was, I thought of this question because of the events of last episode where we took on and killed 5 Deathclaws. Goobers. Show your face. Come on. I dare you. And here's the elevator that we need. Hancock, I gave you a combat shotgun and you are still using that stupid sawed-off double barrel. Let's see if we can get a little sniping action going. Ooh! Took him out. Took that out. Technically speaking, that's the only raider you have to take out to have this mission be considered completed. There should be a Grognak Barbarian.
There we go.
In the bosom of the Corsair Queen. Dang. She do be having a bosom. I didn't see you were finished. got scared. He did. Tried to hit the trick shot. Didn't work. I was expecting it to be dark outside. Oh, okay, that killed that guy. And that's why we put a point into Demolition Expert, because it increased the radius and damage of our explosions. And for anyone that doesn't know, there is a He's dead. He's dead. Where am I getting shot from? Because honestly, I can't tell. Wait, there he is. Ooh, took his leg out. Another one. He gone. He gone. Ooh, he exploded. Not many of you scrubs left. Yeah, we still take fall damage. I thought that was gonna be really cool. He's gonna have 45 rounds. I don't know where this damage is coming from. Like, who's shooting me? Why do these guys just randomly have 5mm? Coming for y'all. Over there, because over there is a bobblehead. So yeah, you get up to the top of the Corvega assembly plant, where this little dome is. Come around here, and it's the repair bobblehead. That's a great skill if you are using power armor, because it means your fusion cores will last a really long time. Look at all there is to see. Some sort of... There's a lighthouse. Oh, that's where the, like, the Children of Adam are. That was where our initial spawn location was. I know that because that lighthouse is really close to it. Okay, so we will talk to you.
For you.
No,
you're damn right we did.
That's the best piece of news we've had around. So we've been talking. We just, if we want things to get, so we're in.
The only way you get at all in this.
Any luck finding that locket?
I've got that locket back for you.
You serious? That's great news. Connie's gonna be speechless. I'm sure she'll go leave.
Boom, 419 experience. You love to see it. Absolutely love to see it.
Yeah?
You know that settlement you sent me to help? They've decided to join the Minutemen.
That's great news. I knew you were the right person for the job. By the way, you should have one. It'll get more and more.
Uh-huh.
I don't think I ever told you.
I figured you'd
have you.
Right. You guys came from Quincy.
That's right. I was with Colonel Hollis's
group. Yeah, yeah, your group came from Quincy. You're a bad leader. We know all this.
The other groups, they just, only a few of us got out alive. Colonel Hollis was dead. We never found it.
As long as you don't give up.
I'm not about to give. That's why I'm talking.
Hey, that means...
I appreciate that.
Okay, I'll do it.
Well now, looks like the Minutemen got a fighting chance, don't they?
Good. Good. Don't worry, I'll be right. The leader of the Minutemen, our last leader, was the one good thing about it. Now it's your...
All right.
Got something to be...
He moves his head a lot when he talks. By the way, another settlement needs your help.
Our scouts have found a promising spot. The trouble is...
Oh, a promising spot for a new settlement.
Before you know it, we'll...
Raiders. Dang, that Brahmin took off. Boy said, I cannot be bothered with this. I think it's time to bring out the hammer. Because I just feel like having screen pollution. I'll pull it out when we actually need it. But this is also why I'm doing it, because I know it's here. Oh. Yes, okay. And I don't really feel like wasting ammo on him. One in here. Hancock? Where's the last one? Come on. Come on. You can do it. Oh my god, he doesn't want to spawn. He's afraid. I was about to just shoot the ground in front of where he was supposed to spawn. I was like, the explosion might be big enough to just take him out. I don't know. She goes out with the other guys. Got Runaround Sue stuck in my head, and I don't know why.
That's it.
Okay, we need to set up a... radio beacon. Which I somehow actually have the materials to do. I'm gonna go scrap the radiation barrels. Just so it's a little bit more pleasant for these people. Preston, we did it. Set up your recruitment beacon. I'm gonna be honest, I really think that,
I cleared out that spot you sent me to. Instead of
that, using a high intelligence build levels you up faster than using a low intelligence idiot savant build. I'll be willing to help defend it. Because with Idiot Savant, for it to be really effective, you have to have it going off almost all the time.
It's a good problem. Uh-huh. I have a solution. Well fortified. It sounds like just what we need right now.
So.
Yeah, let's do this.
We'll do some recon.
Taking Independence. Hey, look, it's Mama Murphy.
Yeah?
So, girl.
Carla.
Hey there. Trading?
I'll take a look, sure.
I got a little bit of everything.
I want to see if I can find, like, a cool... These glasses are part of a mod, by the way. It just adds different sunglasses and stuff into the game. It's one of those things I have turned on and kind of forget that I have it on, so. Okay, I'm gonna fast travel here. One, because I want to discover more locations. Because I might level up before I get to the castle. And two, because it'll keep me out of Boston at all. And I literally, this is like the outskirts of Boston. See, look at all this stuff we can discover. You know, there's a bunch of these relay towers scattered around. And I've never actually, like... I don't think I've ever actually tried to, like, turn them all on and see what they do. Hitting me. Miller family radio signal found. Super mutant radio broadcast signal found. I don't know what those are gonna sound like. Okay, y'all aren't gonna hear me for a second because I want to listen to what these have to say, so bear with me a second. Okay. I don't know if y'all can hear it or not. The Miller family radio signal was basically somebody saying that they were trapped in their bunker. And there were gunshots and stuff like that. Distress signal, Well, I actually think I might know what the distress signal thing is, but... Legendary mole rat broodmother. Come back. I want to kill you. Sorry, Hancock. Oh, that's not even a legendary. Oh, where's the legendary? Oh, hey. Dang, she's chunky. She's real chunky. Lucky baton. Critical shots do double damage and the critical meter feels 15% faster. Okay. Emergency frequency RJ113. Whoa, that is not pleasant. Okay. I don't know what that was either, honestly. Big John Salvage. I don't know what's in Big John Salvage, but we're about to go explore. Find out. Sorry, I thought I could turn my TV up a little bit so that I could hear. I can't do that. Hey, look, we did in fact level up. I knew we would. Legendary Super Mutant Enforcer. Oh. I don't know what he died to, but... Cavalier Synth right arm. Okay, I kind of think Big John Salvage might have a... kind of think there might be a, it's okay with me. It's not, I repeat, not. Why did he fall over? I'm very confused. Oh, hell. That was unexpected. I kind of think... Where are you? Oh, he died. I wasn't sure if he was going to die or not. I think there's something relevant here besides just a bunch of super mutants. Big John Salvage. So what are you gonna do? I've been sitting on a fence and it doesn't make much sense, 'cause you keep me in suspense and you know it. Then you promise to Oh, you can get the railway rifle here. Tales of a junk town jerky vendor. There's a mini nuke, a fusing core. So basically, this is just kind of a location that comes up. This location kind of just pops up for like the static missions that you get. You know, the various like, oh, go here, rescue this person type of. Also, this is where broadcast was coming from, the Miller family broadcast. There's a bunker somewhere. We need to find the bunker. Once we find that, we'll find the key. When we find the key, we can get into the safe. Once we get into the safe, we'll find the goodies. At 47 minutes, we may not even. I kind of figured we'd get distracted when we decided to walk that distance from here. Where? Glowing mutant hound. Okay, where is the bunker? Oh, it actually this may be it. I don't know. Inside the bunker, there's a railway rifle, and I think a fusion core, and potentially a mini nuke. I'm here for all that. I wish you could turn this into a settlement, but I don't think you can. Really cool, though. There's the Tales of a Junk Town jerky vendor. There's the mini nuke, Stimpak, purified water. Okay, still not sure where the rest of it is, but really I'm not that concerned about the railway rifle, so let's move on. We're nowhere close to our to our goal. Everyone tells me he's no good, he doesn't love me like. And here is a military checkpoint with a suit of Exo-1 power armor in it. Coordinates are available in your emergency handbook. So, we know there's a nice little suite of XO1 there. Dark now. I'm not a fan of that. Yes, we're gonna waste time sleeping.
I don't need that.
And I don't need that.
Much better.
He's a demon. He's a devil. Oh, are these the Quincy ruins? Oh, this is Andrew Station. Oh, that is an openable gate. I guess this was like a bus station. For whatever reason, when I think station, I automatically default to train. The final shot in the magazine deals twice the normal damage. South Boston Police Department. What location is this? No, that's that location. Okay. Man did the superhero landing, and it didn't work out very well for him. Okay, the castle's up there. Can I not? This is just a wall. Super Mutants, you've designed your base of operations very poorly. You know what? We can retake the castle. We got time. Me when I got time. I wish frag grenades. Grenades and mines didn't count as like weapons, and they said counted as ammo.
His real name is. Now you can see why I wanted to take it back.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. For 600 years old, it's interesting.
That's right. They don't make them like they used to. We take this place back, people will know we mean business. Our primary objective,
uh-huh.
The wall on this side.
What are we waiting for? Let's just get in there and shoot those lobsters.
No. If we split up, we can flank them from both sides.
That'll be like shooting fish in a barrel.
Why not let them come to us?
Well, let's not overcomplicate this. Just
can't argue with the classics.
Can't argue with the classics.
All right, people. You heard the general. Try not to draw their attention.
I'm just gonna keep destroying the egg clutches. For the win. Looking off in the sky. Very ominously. Queen is. She's about to get rocked. About to drop a nuke on her ass. That didn't kill her. That did. You can really tell on the Myrelurk Queens that it's a... the Myrelurk Queens are definitely mutated lobsters. The regular Myrelurks don't really look like lobsters. They look more like crabs, I guess. Boom. Easy money. Oh, hey, this does the bullets. Ballistic weapons permanently do +5 critical damage. Oh, I don't need that. I don't do crits.
Well, I guess it could be worse. See what you can do with it.
How much power does this need? It needs 10 power. And it's powered up. All right, Preston.
Hey,
I did it.
We really did it. I've been watching the Minutemen fall to pieces for so long. Now we've got to pay off on what we've started. Bring the whole Commonwealth together and make it last this time. So, you know, back to business. But with Radio Freedom up and running, we can broadcast alerts to you anywhere, anytime. Let's get this over with.
Oh yeah, he can broadcast to me anywhere at any time. Exactly what I wanted. I figured as much.
Alive.
Check the stash.
He actually actively picks stuff up. me give that to you, because I kind of want you to wear it instead. Eh. It's not any better or worse. I was going to give you this 5mm, these 5mm rounds. And then you can have this missile launcher I picked up. There we go. Oh, we've got Green Top Nursery, Greenskins, talk to the settlers at Oberlin Station. I might as well go to Oberlin Station. I know for a fact I have it on the map. I can just fast travel there.
The smooth sound of Diamond radio City Radio, broadcasting all day.
This may be a long episode too, just because I have so much fun playing with this character, honestly.
Did the Minutemen send you?
Here's maybe. Yes, I'm here to help.
There's a group of raiders that won't leave. We know where they're coming from, but we can't stand them.
Don't worry.
I hope so.
Mm-hmm.
So. Shoot. I think I ever doubted you.
What can I say? Some people have just got it.
You ain't kidding. It's just real rare. Someone who's not willing to take things the way they're handed to them. Too many folks not willing to get their hands dirty. And too many assholes taking advantage of it. Look at what happened in Diamond City. Before McDonough took over, it was a half-decent place to live. A little stricter than I usually go for, but not terrible. I thought he and I had a pretty happy childhood. But then he decides he's gonna try and get elected with his anti-ghoul crusade. Mankind for McDonald's.
That must have been when he got replaced with a synth. He got families with kids. Oh, spoiler alert.
Drag folks they call neighbor out of their homes and throw them to the ruins.
How could they do something like that?
There'd always been a pretty big gulf between the folks living in the stands and folks down on the field. McDonough ran on it because he thought enough of those upper stands assholes would vote for him. Guess he was right. I remember storming into his office above the stands after the inauguration speech. He was just standing there, staring out the window, watching as the city turned on the ghouls. He didn't even look at me. Just said, "I did it, John. It's finally mine." Should have killed him right there, but I don't think it would have changed anything. Instead, I pleaded with him, begged him to call it off. He said he couldn't. He had nothing against the ghouls. He was just carrying out the word.
Couldn't betray the voters. Man, this is very reflective on American politics.
Mile-long smile. He never smiled like that when we were kids. I didn't even recognize him.
He murdered those ghouls.
Him and that whole damn city. I still wasn't a ghoul at this point, so I didn't have to leave. I couldn't bring myself to stay in that cesspool after that. I'd been sneaking off the good neighbor for years to get decent chems, so I knew the safe routes. I managed to track down a couple of the families, lead them there, but most couldn't get used to the good neighbor lifestyle. I brought them food for a couple of weeks, but after a while, they just disappeared. Folks in Diamond City signed their death warrants, and all the good people were willing to just sit by and watch. I felt like I was the only one who saw how screwed up things truly were. We couldn't just pretend things were fine. Still feel that way. Or I did. Until I met you. I know I run my mouth, but having someone who sees the world for what it is and is willing to do something about it, it's meant a lot to me. I feel damn lucky to have you as a friend.
You'd flirt with him.
I feel exactly the same, Hancock. It's been a hell of a ride thus far.
Then here's to a long road with plenty of ammo.
It's really easy to make him happy.
You probably weren't looking for a history lesson, were you? You want to hit the road?
Now, some of the other companions you can have, it is really hard to get them to like you. like MacReady. It takes MacReady and Deacon both take forever, and they're real particular about stuff. And
Cleo.
MacReady's real easy to cheese, though. It's just, I think it's MacReady.
Let's see what you got.
Murder and mayhem at a discount.
There's like certain places you can go where you can like basically keep picking locks and resetting him. Give me some more 45 rounds. It is nice kind of focusing on one specific ammo type, or like one specific type of gun, basically. Where did Hancock go? Oh, there you are.
Hey, wait there.
Gotcha.
Come on.
Give me that. And give me that.
Hey, Cleo.
I hope you're buying.
Uh-huh. Let's see what you have.
Murder and mayhem at...
If you hit upon something, don't bother telling me it's an heirloom. I'm probably older than whatever it is you're selling.
So Daisy is a ghoul from, like, the...
Got any work?
When the bombs dropped. Super mutants have taken. She's like nearly as old as we are.
I got a lot of fond memories of that place from when I was a girl. And human. You get those lumbering brutes out of there, I'll pay you 200 caps.
You got a deal, Daisy.
Thanks. Hey, while you're there, could you return this book for me? It's from the library. Don't even ask how long it's been overdue.
Public knowledge. Alright, we'll do this real quick. We'll go kill those raiders. Where's the boss of the library? So literally to do this, all you have to do is come over here to the door, which we've already opened. There shouldn't be any super mutants left in here. There might be. Turn this on. Yes. Oh, nope, there are still super mutants here. Alright, well, let's take them dudes out and continue on. They appear to be down here fighting my little robot friends. Bodied. Oops. Well, now I've got a... I gotta kill everyone because these robots are pissed off at me.
You just heard crawl out through the fallout.
Where is that terminal even plugged into? I don't know. I don't know. Freddy got this one? Yeah, okay.
Some or all of you may have heard of that old Parson's Asylum.
Okay, there's that quest done.
Stay away from it.
Now we'll go over here to Backstreet Apparel. Kill those raiders.
I guess no one told a group of raiders about that, but word is they attacked it recently. You'd think that might be...
Sorry, guy. Shot him in the shoulder.
Hard to imagine a time when carrying a Geiger counter was a positive thing, but there you go.
Light him up!
Time's up, asshole!
Well, I don't know, but I've been told uranium ore is worth more than gold.
This is another one of those missions where you don't actually have to kill everyone, you just have to kill the leader. Thanks, lady. Sorry about, you know, your body. It was an accident. Sort of. I mean, I definitely meant to shoot you. I just didn't necessarily mean to have you explode into a bunch of pieces. Do y'all like how half the time I can't even be bothered to unlock stuff?
I'm going out to stake me some government land.
Uranium fever has gone and got me down. Well, you pack up your things, you head out again into some unknown spot where nobody's been. You reach a spot where your fortune lies. You find it's been staked by 17 other guys. Well, I ain't kidding, I ain't gonna quit. That bug's done caught me and I've been bit. So with a Geiger counter and a pick in my hand, I'll keep right on staking that government land. Uranium fever has gone and got me down. Uranium fever has spread.
We could go get dog meat back if I knew where he was.
I'm going out to stake me some government.
I took care of those raiders for you.
The best news I've heard in a long time.
You know, they talk about cigarettes giving you cancer. I just thought of this. The ones that you can get in the, like, that are lying around in this, they've got to be, like, instant cancer. Like, super cancer. Because these are all, they're all pre-war cigarettes. Which would mean that they've also been exposed to radiation on top of all the other, you know, carcinogens in them. Here's another one of those relay terminals. Poor guy. We didn't pick up anything. Oh, yes, we did. Boston City Works signal. Garbled radio signal beacon. Alright, I gotta listen to these again. I'll be back. Well, I couldn't make heads or tails of any of that. I think the garbled radio signal might have been it might have been like an alien signal, because those do exist. I just don't know if you can get one in Fallout 4 or not. If you can, that's probably what that is. Oh, hello, Mr. Ghoul. Oh, he's alive. Radio beacon signal. Shouldn't it get stronger the closer we get to where am I going? Oh, hello, gunners. Theoretically, I would think that oh, we found it. Okay, maybe it is. Maybe it does get stronger the closer we... No, we lost it again. Interesting. Stress signal, signal lost. There was really faint talking in the distress signal. Hello, Mr. Yowboy. Hey, we leveled up. Sweet. Okay, got that perk of Rifleman. So, I think it's bloody mess time. We're just gonna be actively sitting on one perk in big leagues for the foreseeable future. I may go 3 into medic. And then after that, I can get 1 perk into armor, 1 perk into gun nut. And then after that, go into science. And then all that he would have left, theoretically, would be heavy gunner, big leagues, 1 perk in rifleman, 1 more in medic, 1 more in bloody mess, whatever we want to do in fortune finder and scrounger, which we kind of have been ignoring. But discovered Vault 81. Yeah, part of the reason why I record these all so far in advance is because I just want to play. I feel like I've created a really fun character. Why? You stupid bug. You're not even doing damage. Thank you, Hancock. Oh, I honestly think you did more damage to me than to the bug, but... What are you gonna do? Okay. Oh, you know what, while we're over here? There's a really sad story about this place. So, see that overturned boat? First of all, while you're here, don't turn on the little bug zapper, because it'll hurt. Commonwealth weaponry. Protect yourself. See him anywhere. The three sons are up next with worry, worry, worry. So I'm not gonna read the whole terminal entry. Basically, it talks. Well, I should probably open it up and see what it says, just to Please select an entry. Something about a locket. Oh, September 12th, that's my birthday. Oh yeah, his wife had a locket. She died, and then he lost it out in the boat. That's the boat. He went to find it. And in this box is Edwin's key, 45 round. More down here, I think, is the locket, but. Yep, right there. Great, now I gotta go back into the water. Holy crap. There's a lot of junk down here. Oh, remember what I said earlier about stingwings? Now he's gone. Nope, that's a ranger that's getting bodied by him, okay. Okay, we can open the safe. Not anything super crazy. But that is a little bit of a kind of sad tale. I can't fast travel till I kill this thing. Okay. Keep a knocking, but you can't come in. Keep a knocking, but you can't come in. Okay, now go back to Good Neighbor to talk to Daisy. Come back tomorrow night and try again.
Step through the gate.
Oh, Cleo.
Don't worry. I only test the weapons on customers I don't
know. Oh, you actually weren't who I was intending to talk to, but oh well.
I'll take a look, sure.
Each weapon tested on.
Okay. And now we will talk to
you back? How'd it go with the library? Get rid of those super mutants.
You're dang right.
I managed to fight my way through the library. Oh, and I dropped off that book of yours.
Oh, I know it was an odd request, but thanks for here's your money.
Don't have no hand.
So there's a couple more missions we can do here in Good Neighbor. I might as well pick them up because we can kind of do them whenever. I agree. Brotherhood of Steel better stay out of here.
Are you
it's an open door, but it's like a philosophically open door, okay? Get the hell out.
Excuse me.
Boss Morosky don't like to be disturbed. Be quick.
Interesting. I think I know who that person is.
Took a walk out in the fence.
And fun fact, if you come up here in one of the vet bedrooms, is Mr. Vault Tech Rep. I don't know how he can tell who it is from underneath our costume.
Right.
Yeah, I'm from Sanctuary.
What? You don't remember me? Or you? Look at you. Too hot.
The vault had these pods that froze us in place.
What? Well, I had to get to the future, though.
Uh-huh.
Look at me.
I'm so sorry. I didn't know this would happen.
You know, you're the only other person I met from... Oh, God. I've been so alone here. No common...
Hey, you know, you could head back to Sanctuary. I'll come visit. I promise.
Really? You...
I believe that's a fairly easy...
Okay. I'll head over there right now.
Oh, I didn't...
Promise,
I guess it makes sense that Hancock would want us keeping people in Sanctuary. You know what? Where's our most recent... We'll reload that. I'd rather keep Hancock happy. That's right. It's me from Sanctuary Hills.
Sanctuary Hills, right?
Yeah, I'm from Sanctuary.
What? Are you?
Uh-huh. The vault had these pods that froze us in place. I only thawed out recently.
What? Vault Tech never told me that. Unbelievable. I had to get to the future the hard way, living through the filth, the decay, and the bloodshed. Look at me. I'm a ghoul, a freak.
I'm so sorry. I didn't know this would happen.
You know, you're the only other person I met from before. I've been so alone here. No Commonwealth settlement. Once a ghoul with 200 years of Vault Tech sales experience.
Yeah, yeah.
Good neighbor seems like an okay place. Just make the most of it.
You know, if you heard that same keep your chin up shit for 2 centuries, you might feel a bit different. Just leave me alone.
Yeah, well, he's probably upset with us, but Hancock's not, and that's all that matters. Well, he wouldn't have been upset with us anyway. He just disliked it.
Excuse me.
Oh, man, someone new. You need some jet, man? Homebrewed? Reasonable prices?
You have any work?
Yeah, actually, you know the gunners, right? The high-end mercenaries? Well, I mean, just...
All right, Fred. We have...
You're the best.
All right.
Before you even start, let's get to the point. We have rooms. One room specific.
Well, that's a great one, isn't it?
Not today.
Then you came to the wrong place.
Dang, okay.
I just clean up around here.
This guy, does he want something?
Hey there. Your new
Rufus Rubens.
What do you think of the place? By the
following. Seems like my kind of place.
Bit of a rough town, but beats cowering behind...
Name's Rufus. I do repairs around here. I'm usually here or drinking that swill char. Looking for parts?
I could use work.
Don't know if you've had the beer down at the third rail.
Found this holotape while doing repairs.
Sure. Thing is, it was never delivered, which is where you come.
I'm in. Let's do it.
Great. So, when you leave town, make your way around East.
All right, so find the brewing machine. Okay, so that quest could be a bit of a pain in the butt because it is a escort mission. And the problem with escort missions is it's an escort mission, so we have to follow the person. Or the robot, specifically. And with that in mind, we have to go through downtown Boston to do it, so we have to save really frequently.
Hi.
Good neighbor's crazy. Thefts, murders, worse.
I hear you. It's a mess out there.
It's rough in the best of days.
Sure.
You ever listen to the Silver Shroud? That's
my family and I used to listen to every new episode.
You mean when they first aired? How? The last broadcast was hundreds of years ago.
I was in cryogenic storage for a long time.
I'm older than you, Britt.
Oh man, that's amazing. You're just like Mr. Abominable from episode 83.
Mr. Abominable, you mean?
Wasn't he a caveman?
Yeah, that's the one. They found him in an iceberg off the harbor. Boy, if you just woke up, the world these days must take some getting used to.
It seems like people are finally rebuilding and recovering from the nuclear war.
Maybe in some parts, like Diamond City, but over here, we got a ways to go. I got a question for you. What if the Silver Shroud was real, with his black trench coat and gleaming silver submachine gun? I got a plan to bring him to life. So we can fight bad guys and give the rest of us a symbol of something better.
Good on you for trying to make the world better.
Worth trying anything once.
I just have to do something, you know? I've built my own custom machine gun. But to make this work, I still need the most important. And they actually got one here in Boston. They made it for the TV.
I'll get the costume for you.
You're gonna do this? Before the bombs fell, they were filming the Silver Shroud pilot over at Hubris Comics. So that's where you'll find it. You're the best.
Alright, the Silver Shroud. So we've picked up several missions. But we will do in varying orders. Obviously, you can't do them all at once. So does Irma just sit here on the lounge and, like, chill all the time? Fun fact, if you come here before you find the railroad, Deacon will be in here. Or I think he's, like, outside of, he's just kind of, like, hiding as a drifter out here. And then he's also, I think once you do the whole memory thing with Valentine, I think he's in there. Again, just chilling. Okay, might as well go turn this into Preston, and then I can drop off any. What did I have to do at Abernathy Farm? Each time I look at your face, one more tomorrow to see heaven in your eyes. To have your Preston hasn't made his way back from the he hasn't made his way back from the castle yet. That's why he's here. Except he's not actually, he's okay, he'll be in Sanctuary by the time we get there.
Hey. I took care of the raiders that were harassing that settlement you sent me to. The people there have decided to join our cause.
That's great news. One day, we'll be strong enough to drive that scum out of the Commonwealth for good. As usual, I've got some... Our scouts have found a promising spot for a new settlement. But nobody's gonna want to move there until the bug infestation is taken care of.
Sure.
Before you know it...
Uh-huh.
Man, Preston's tired. Haffington Boathouse. Get him strong. Ow. Hey. Get out of my power armor, Sturgis.
I need you to get out of your power armor.
Breath. Not cool. Yeah, you know, Hancock feels about power armor.
All right, now we're talking.
I left it here for a reason. It is not for you to use. It is decorative.
You have the sight. It has to be able to.
Okay, well. That is going to be all for this episode. A nice hour and a half long endeavor. What did we even do? I don't know. We talked to Virgil. Helped some settlements. Got the castle back. That was cool. Took down a Myrlark Queen, which surprisingly took two mini nukes. I'm a little surprised by that. And picked up some side quests that we can do to help the people of Good Neighbor, which I think Hancock will greatly appreciate. So yeah, we'll start taking care of those Good Neighbor side quests in the next episode, and probably rescue these settlements. Get them going. Maybe we can do some railroad stuff. I mean, really, most of what we have is just like, you know, filler stuff. Filler. That. I could do that just for some free experience. It's like, I don't even have to commit to anything. I can just go help them. I could do the Mechanical Menace DLC stuff at some point. But anyway, that is for a later time and a later date. I will see you guys in the next episode. This is Friar Chuck saying bye-bye.